Welcome to Wilbur D. Rao Middle School, where the teachers are great and every single kid is cool. Truly learn with the common goal. We are safe, respectful, and responsible. Home to math minds, some of the best readers, musicians, athletes, scholars, and web leaders. Lots happening in this wonderful place, and there's only one way to stay up to date. So if you got a case of the sandbox blues, hit the YouTube, check the Shamrock News. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Not a thing that we cannot do. Growth mindset, it's the Shamrock News. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? So if you got a case of the sandbox blues, hit the YouTube, check the Shamrock News. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Not a thing that we cannot do. Growth mindset, it's the Shamrock News. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on?
Lock in. Welcome, 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 Wilbur D. Rao Middle School Shamrocks.
It feels like springtime is in the air, and we are beyond excited for spring break and the rest of the year.
I'm Leah, aka Megamind.
And I'm Andres, aka Whitney.
Let's start things off with an appreciation for those who came to the dance last Friday. We had a blast, and we greatly appreciate everyone who was well behaved and having fun.
What's gonna be your favorite part of the dance?
Probably the food.
Soda.
Soda. Well, y'all have fun setting up. Have a good day.
It's going so good.
What's your favorite part so far?
Probably skipping all five periods today.
What? Is the lights being difficult to you?
A little bit. It's kind of tall up here. But, yeah.
That's fair. And you guys are helping her not fall down, right?
Yep.
All right, y'all have a good time. So who are we here with today?
Aaliyah McNaughton.
Yep, you heard that. How's the dance setup going?
I think it's going pretty good. I'm trying to find like stuff to do right now.
How long have you been here for? Is this first period?
Yeah, it's this first period, yeah.
You must be tired. Well, have a good time. Yep. What's your favorite part right now?
My what?
Your favorite part?
The decorating.
Yeah? What's your favorite part right now?
Me, cause what?
What's gonna be your favorite part?
The drinks.
Drinks.
Like the
sodas. You got trembled.
Tomorrow's my, not tomorrow, but next week's Saturday is my birthday. Wish me a happy birthday. And yep.
Today's book showcase is What's Left of Me by Kat Zane. I would recommend this book to anyone who loves science fiction. It's about Ava and Addie. They are two people in one body. They are two different personalities, and one of them is dominant. In this book, they're supposed to be a dominant soul, but one of them does not fade away, and they're considered a hybrid, which is not acceptable from their world. And being a hybrid is considered really dangerous, and they are a danger to the world and to themselves, is what doctors and people have said. I recommend this book to anyone who likes a good plot twist and sci-fi.
The Brown Middle School Art Contest has come to a close, and the school has chosen its favorites.
We'd like to thank everyone for participating in the Round Middle School Art Contest. We've tallied the results and 152 of you voted, which is awesome. Here are the final tally totals. In fifth place, we have a tie, piece number 9 by Marcos and piece number 11 by Unknown. Sorry, we don't have the name on the back of it, but your art is very pretty. In fourth place, we have number 5 by Susanna.
In third place, we have piece number 10. Once again, by an artist whose name we were unable to locate, but we still love your piece so, so, so much. In second place, we have piece number 4 by Evelyn. And in first place, we have piece number 1 by Ruby Gatos.
Come down to Mr. Dixon's room to collect your prize. Once again, thank you for everyone who's participating. The art contest will be back next year at Rowell Middle School.
There's still some time to sign up for track and field, which starts the next Monday after spring break.
We go to spring break starting this Friday. When we get back, it's time for track and field to start. Monday, April 1st, 2024 is a very first practice after school from 4:20 to 5:30 p.m. In order to sign up, you must use the form in the Rowell Hub. There is no paper forms. Repeat, there is no paper forms! You will have to create an account with your family ID, and then you will sign up online. We recommend that you and your people remember the family ID login, username, and password, because you'll use this program to sign up for sports in high school as well. In order to participate, you need to sign up here, and then also have a doctor's physical approval for your participation. If you're struggling to sign up or get a physical, go see Mr. Hayes in room 337. Today we're going to talk about jumping. That's right, we talk about some throwing, and we talked about some hurdling and running. Now it's time to discuss the leaping portion of track. First, we have high jump. The high jump consists of 3 huge mats kept together with a tarp. Then we have 2 posts that hold the high jump bar. The objective is to run up to the bar and jump over it and onto the mat without knocking the bar over. Whoever jumps the highest wins. The other jumping event is the long jump.
For long jump, you'll be running down a track straightway until you get to a white line. Then you'll jump from the line without stepping over it, and you'll land in the sand pit. People will measure how far you've jumped by using a tape measure that goes from the back of where you landed to the white line. Whoever jumps the farthest wins. If you join track, you are able to compete in either of these activities, or in some case, both of them.
Both of them!
Got some business to handle.
Get signed up, and we will see you on Monday, April 1st, to start running, hurling, throwing, and leaping!
Hey there, looking for some updates on the Rowell Middle School Podcast Network? The Raw Middle School Podcast Network is in full swing and posting more and more episodes.
We got two new episode recaps for the good people of Raw Middle School.
First, Jose, Hayden, and Kennedy linked up with Mr. Long from the NCSC District Office for our collaboration podcast.
So, Mr. Long, we do have a few questions for you.
All right, lay them on me.
I have some personal ones as
okay.
well. From that little description we just got, I have some questions of my own.
It's good to be here, by the way. We do not have any other middle schools in the district that do their own podcast. So this is a podcast within a podcast. We've got the Rao Middle School podcast inside the Proud to be NCSD podcast. This will be fun.
Mr. Long is a longtime employee of the NCSD, and he was a principal for many years.
He's best known for some of his wild parody videos he's made to inspire community. The walking is like useless, but
it's just so. I like Chromebooks, and I cannot lie. Scouter's Mountain, you can't deny. When you open it up right in front of your face and you log in the space, you get launched. And you have to stare, because you know your teacher was there. Can't believe she's so caring. I'm hooked, and I can't stop staring. Oh, baby, another assignment. State standard alignment.
He currently is the host of the Proud to be NCSD podcast. He brought his podcast to our podcast.
First, students ask him about his career. Then he asked Rao students about what it's like to be a middle schooler in today's day and age.
What's currently going on in eighth grade? What's it like to be in eighth grade? And how much are you looking forward to this school year being over?
I feel like it being in eighth grade is like good, and like it's not like overstressing, but it's fun and all, but there's this sometimes where you like get stuck a lot in eighth grade, but it's really like calm.
In an additional podcast, Layla, Rayleigh, Aaliyah, and Sienna sat down to talk about their basketball season and discuss many more interesting topics.
Hey Shamrockians, I'm Rayleigh.
I'm Aaliyah.
I'm Layla.
I'm Sienna.
And we're back with another podcast. I swear, whenever he talks about that, he's like, in sixth grade, Rayleigh and Sienna just started basketball, and they've grown so much.
They're just the two of us that's been on our team since, like, the dawn of time.
Once long time ago.
Be sure to tune in both episodes on the Rao Middle School Podcast Network.
Available wherever you get your podcasts! Two, round team!
Looking for some fun this week? The Letting Library is having a walk-in.
I'm locked in.
I'm gonna be so bored over spring break.
Same, there's nothing to do, and I just want somewhere to like hang out with my friends.
Guys, I've got just the thing.
Like, it would be awesome if there's just a spot where we could play video games or something.
Ooh, or like read a little bit.
Wow, do I have the place for you,
Or just like arts and crafts or board games.
Ooh, yeah. Or like, ooh, snacks.
Alan J, yeah.
Really, just please listen to me.
OMG, right back, what?
Thank you. The Letting Library is hosting a teen lock-in on Friday, March 22nd, 2024.
What's a lock-in?
It's literally everything you just said. Teens are taking over the library from 5:30 to 8 p.m.
And there will be games and snacks?
Yes, I literally just said that.
You can go.
Anybody up until 12th grade, it starts between 5:30 and 6, and pickup is between 7:45 and 8.
Should we go?
Heck yeah.
The Letting Library teen lock-in goes down Friday, March 22nd, 2024. Be there!
Woo!
This Friday is the first Friday for Mr. T and Mr. Diggs' morning basketball skills and drills clinic.
Attention all Rao Hoopers of all age and gender identities. Do you want to improve your ball handling?
Get your shot locked in.
make passes that aren't wild and all over the place,
then you need to come into Mr. T's and Mr. Dix's skill and drill seminars at Rao Middle School on Friday mornings.
On Friday mornings at Rao Middle School, Mr. T and Mr. Dix will open the gym for kids to come in and work on their game.
Students will get a chance to improve their jump shot.
Students will also work on moves and finishes that will help them get buckets and game. You will need to get your own transportation to school. The seminar will start at 8 a.m. You'll need to show Mr. Dix and Mr. T your student field before you play. The expectation is that students who participate have zero D's or F's. If you have a D or an F, you will not be able to hoop.
Also, remember to bring some deodorant so that you can apply some after the workout before you spend the day in class. If you have any questions, ask Mr. Dix in room 225. The first Skills and Drills seminar goes down on Friday, March 22nd, 2024. So come out and get your game right, so you can be like Reese Law, who makes three-pointers.
Make sure to sign up for volleyball summer camp at the cheerleading clinics.
I took so many in my anchor segment.
What's up, all my bumpers, settlers, and spikers?
Are you interested in participating in some summer volleyball?
Waukee High School Volleyball Program is hosting a volleyball camp this summer from Monday, August 5th to Thursday, August 8th.
This camp will take place at Milwaukee High School.
In order to sign up, go to your grade level hub in Google Classroom and then fill out the form in the volleyball announcement.
When you fill out the form, please enter the grade that you will become in September.
If you're in sixth grade now, sign up for the seventh grade slot.
Middle schoolers will participate in the camp from 3 to 5 p.m.
Current eighth graders who will be in high school next year will participate in the camp from 6 to 8 p.m.
The cost of the camp is $60. If you have any questions, visit Miss York in the 100 hall.
Come on and work on your volleyball skills before the fall season starts.
Miss Larson is the Milwaukee Mustang cheerleading head coach, and she is running some open clinics for all aspiring cheerleaders.
They will be held the first four Wednesdays of April.
Mondays and Wednesdays, last week of April through the end of May.
The cost for these clinics are $2.
From 4:30 to 6:30 p.m.
So, to recap, Miss Larson and the Milwaukee Mustangs cheer squad will be having open clinics every Wednesday for the first 4 weeks of April, and then the last week of April all the way till the end of May, it goes to two times a week, 4:30 to 6:30 in the Milwaukee High School Commons, $2 a clinic. Come hang out and get ready for tryouts. But wait, when are tryouts?
Tryouts are June 3rd to June 6th.
Thanks for joining us, Rao Shamrocks.
We'll see you next time on the Shamrock News.
Same Shamrock time.
Same Shamrock place.
Peace.
Okay.
What's your name?
Vanessa.
Who'd you like to give Shamrock a shout-out to?
Miss H.
Okay. Who'd you like to give a shout out to?
My name is Ann. I wanted to go class with Miss H.
What's your name?
Mr. Richmond.
Who would you like to give a Shamrock shout out to?
I want to give a Shamrock shout out to all the eighth graders who've done a good job during state testing.
What's your name?
My name is Anthony.
And who would you like to give a Shamrock shout out to?
Yazzie, otherwise I'm going to get canceled by the Federation of something. I don't know.
Me. What's your name?
Calder.
And who would you like to give a Shamrock shout out to?
Alex, Maddie, and Miranda for doing great on the poster for the dance.
I love it too. I agree. Who would you like to give a Shamrock shout out to?
I'd like to give a Shamrock shout out to all my friends. So that would include Izzy, Charlotte, Raymond, Tayshawn, everyone who I know and consider my best friend.
Have you been kind to anyone this week?
Yes.
Would you like to name who?
You, Ansel, Davis, all my pookies, and my teachers.
Would you like to give a Shamrock shout out to anybody?
Say it.
Would you like to give a Shamrock shout out to anybody here?
Or not here.
Wait.
Or not here.
I would like to give a Shamrock shout out to myself and my brothers, because number one, my brothers, because they're rats, and number two, for myself, because Hi, my name is Yazzie, and I'd like to give a Shamrock shout out to my amazing girlfriend, Alyssa.
Welcome, welcome, Wilbur D. Rowe, Middle School Shamrock.
Read
it. Just keep it going. Okay.
It feels like springtime is in the air, and we are beyond excited for spring break and the rest of the year.
Ow!
We got a film.
Evelyn? Let me read that again. In second...
Check.
Ready. Just do that. And give me an M to spell.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1.
Give me an M.
Give me a U.
U. You got a kick.
I can't breathe.
You got a kick.
Stop. I can't. Just jump. I'll pull a hand.
Woo! I don't know. We'll figure it out. Ready?
4:30 to 6:30 p.m.
From 4:30 to 6:30 p.m.
I recommend this book to anyone who likes a good plot twist and sci-fi.
Done a bad job.
Dang.
Yeah.
Okay. For you!
I don't want to be filmed, Yazzie.
I don't.
Stop. Don't talk to me. Hi, my name is Yassi, and I'd like to give a Shamrock shout out to my amazing girlfriend, Alyssa.
Howdy, fella. Oh, that's a break.
You recording? Attention all route hoopers, all ages and all gender identities. Do you want to improve your ball handling so you can do this?
Make passes that aren't wild and all over the place. Wait, no, we need to redo that. I need to throw a bad pass.
You got this, Kennedy.
Right there. Right there.
You missed!
No!
You missed! Henry, you could have caught it!
No, I have script in one hand and a mic in another. I can't.
They're actually laying on your boot. Okay.
It's gone 9:30. It's sand. You can wipe it off. Guys, this is Kenny being coach 101. Alright, he's getting ready for the jump. 3, 2, 1, go! Wait, sorry, I wasn't recording. All right, redo that. You need to actually land on your boot scoop. Start. 3, 2, 1, go. He's going to go over it. He makes it. That's like minus 3 feet, but we got it. We did. All right. Wait, they're actually really fast. Oh. Oh, my God. They're actually going far. Boys. Stop acting like boys. Act like a pretty girl. Act like a pretty girl for Aunt Mama.
Never get to the sand pit first win.
Oh my God. Actually, Henry's actually trying for once.
Now do it. Jump.